Hey everybody, thanks for tuning in today. I am Kelly Alexa, and today we are going to talk about how to make money in health and wellness, or how to monetize in a really good way your passion for health, wellness, fitness, or all of the above. I'm going to help you. I've got a lot of detail for you in this video. By the end of this video, you're going to understand all of the options, and I believe you're going to have a clear idea of what path you should be taking. You're also going to learn why I've made the decision just recently to join a company, a network marketing company called Isagenics, and have this as one of my primary sources of income. You'll be very excited to learn more. I'm excited to share with you, so let's dive in. Okay, so what am I going to go over in this video? I'm going to start with giving you a little bit of background on my professional experience. You'll understand a little bit more about my corporate American experience, as well as the successful companies I founded, and again, how I came to learn about the best ways to really make money from a fitness, health, and wellness passion. Number two, we're going to go into, because of that experience, all of my corporate experience, startup experience, etc., what were the lessons that I learned on what not to do and what to do to really make a solid, really and solid income for yourself, not just an income, but develop a wealth building strategy. I mean, because we're not just looking to get by, we're looking to build and build and build on our income. And then I'll tell you again what I referenced at the beginning of this video. Why did I choose Isagenics as one of my primary ventures that I'm going to be, you know, going all in on? And then I'll wrap everything up at the end, give you some options, let you know what's coming in the next video, because you're definitely going to want to tune into that if this video resonates with you, which I know it will. And then we'll wrap up and move on. Let's go. All right, so let me give you a lowdown on my professional background. After college, I graduated from the Ohio State University. I graduated from college and originally intended to go to law school. Go figure. Now I'm dating a lawyer. But anyway, I intended to go to law school and I got impatient. Frankly, I just didn't want to take the LSAT, and I ended up diving into a corporate sales job. I was in corporate sales in corporate America for the better part of, I think, 16, 17 years, and always had I had great companies that I worked for, great bosses. I always did really well hitting and exceeding my quota. I made good money. I wouldn't say I made outstanding money. I was always, you know, at the six-figure point, but I never was crushing it because I always, frankly, took the safe jobs. I'll get into why I took the safe jobs, meaning high base salary, lower percentage of commission, on another video. Because that's part of the reason that I created my whole online course for women. Again, we'll cover that in another video. But I did well. I had a good gig going, and I never, ever, ever saw myself as an entrepreneur. Fast forward to 2011, I jumped ship and founded my own company called Fitfluential. We were the first ever fitness influencer network. Back at that time, we really were more of what we'd call a blogger network. Back then, the term influencer wasn't being thrown around the way it was today. Most of the time back then, if you wanted to be on social media marketing campaigns with brands, you had to be a blogger, sometimes a YouTuber, but definitely a blogger. So we were a blogger network, and we were the first niche network focused on fitness. And I founded this company, and much to my surprise, I had a profitable seven-figure business, and I ran that company as CEO and founder for the better part of 6 to 7 years. Now, I shut that company down 2 years late, because the truth is I really stopped enjoying it about 4 years in. That's another video I'll get into, some of those lessons learned. But I shut that company down last year, and I founded another company, Socially Fit Services, in January of 2019. Within 30 days, I had that company to a profitable six-figure mark on its way to seven figures. And I also launched in March of this year a passion project, which is called The Opposite of Nice Isn't Nasty, Sales and Business Training for Women Who Want to Earn Their Worth. Now, that course is an absolute passion project for me, but it's also something that I'm going to be relaunching in January because I'm expanding it, and it's something I want to give more of my attention to. Now, all of that experience considered, I want to let you know about some of the lessons that I've learned in both my corporate America world and in my experience founding successful startups and founding my own project. Okay, so what are the lessons that I've learned from all of that business experience. And really what I'm talking about here, what are the lessons that I've learned on how to make money? Number one, you don't make money if you want to build a long-term, sustainable wealth-building strategy for yourself and your loved ones and your family. You won't get there by working in corporate America. Now, this is my opinion, of course, and this is my opinion based on research and also on my own experience. The number one thing that women in particular need to keep in mind is that the wage gap has not disappeared and the glass ceiling has not disappeared, period. Men are being paid more on the dollar than women are, period. And the glass ceiling is a real thing. In fact, the truth is, earlier this year, when I was at this beginning of a fork in the road in my professional life, I had gotten to the point after founding Socially Fit Services where we were busy, we had all these clients coming in. I knew that we were on our way to seven figures of profitable, you know, another profitable business at seven figures, and I wasn't enjoying the work. And I knew that I didn't want to get myself in the position of being this workaholic who's making great revenues but isn't living to enjoy it. I didn't want to live that way anymore. I did that with Fitfluential. So I was at a fork in the road, and the truth is I was actually considering some positions that I actually interviewed for in corporate America. And it was, you know, some very nice titles and potential nice compensation package. But the truth is, when I evaluated what most companies could afford to pay me and what I was actually worth, I knew that right off the bat, I was not going to be able to be paid what I was worth. That most companies, because of my experience and because of my expertise and what I brought to the table, were probably going to offer me half of my worth right up front. And then if I accepted that, I'd be compromising my integrity because I'd be working for less than my value. And then I'd be working my way back up to my current value. And that would probably be the ceiling. So that's what I know about corporate America, okay? Now, I'm actually making sure that I reference my notes here so I don't forget to make some of my points. So corporate America, not the way to go. For those of you that are bloggers or influencers and you've been making money, maybe some of you are even Fitfluential, former Fitfluential ambassadors that are watching this, or you're just, you know, in the fitness, health, and wellness space and you've made money with sponsored content, sponsored blog posts. Maybe you're a brand ambassador for a brand. Those can be what I would call fun money. It is absolutely, without question, not a sustainable way to make money, period. And I will argue this till the cows come home with anybody. Take it from me, I've owned a network. I still know several other women who are running successful networks. I know several other women who got sick of it as well and sold their networks because from a business owner's perspective, the profitability margins are just not there. And from an influencer, from an individual influencer perspective, you have to understand that there's absolutely no long-term stability. Even if a brand has chosen to work with you all year and they give you a contract, don't fool yourself into thinking that that's guaranteed money. Don't fool yourself into thinking that they might change their entire marketing approach in the next quarter, in the next year. And at that point, if they do change their marketing approach, their budgets will change, or their choice of using you as a brand representation is going to change. So putting yourself in the position where you're depending on sponsored content from brands or PR agencies that are hiring you on behalf of brands, that's not a sustainable way to make money. In no way is it a way for you to be making wealth. So that's not a solid way for you to be looking at making income. What I referenced at the beginning of this video is true for anybody, and that is, whatever it is that you choose to do, you should be looking at making multiple streams of income. Now, some people say, I want five streams of income. Some people want three. Some people will end up having, you know, three primary sources of income. They'll have two or three that are like extra money, but hey, it all adds up. And some of the things that you can consider, again, if you are a blogger, you can make money from affiliate opportunities. You can absolutely make money from sponsored post opportunities. it's just not, again, predictable or guaranteed. So always keep that in mind. And again, in those cases, you're taking the audience that you've worked so hard to develop a relationship with, and you're promoting somebody else's products when really the best long-term strategy is to promote your own ventures where you have a vested interest and you can actually be earning ideally compounded income on a long-term basis. So you, as a blogger, as an influencer, you can make money from affiliate partnerships, from sponsored content, from ads if you're on a blog. Also, if you're, you know, hey, if you're a YouTuber, you can be making money from the ads that display on a YouTube video below. You can also make your own product. You can have an ebook. You can have a private Facebook group, a subscription model. There's any number of ways that you can make money as a blogger. You can also publish your own book. You can self-publish or you can get a book deal. A lot of times becoming a blogger will lead to getting your own book deal. I can't tell you how many of our Fitfluential ambassadors are now published cookbook authors or published authors. One of the things to know, traditional publishing is going to pay you ultimately about a dollar a book. It's not going to make you a millionaire, okay? It will open doors for you. So that's something to consider. You can also start your own company. I started Fitfluential. I started Socially Fit Services. I launched my own product. Those are ways for you. And when I'm talking about product, I'm talking about my course. A product can be a course. It can be a six-week program where you're training people. I'm thinking of a lot of the fitness programs that I know. It can be an ebook. It can be any combination of the above. And then, of course, there's always the opportunity to look into a network marketing business. I referred to that earlier, and I'm going to go into that shortly, but network marketing is a $186 billion industry that has a lot of tremendously appropriate products for those of you that are in the fitness, health, and wellness space. And even those, there's companies out there that are, I would say, complementary to fitness, health, and wellness. So in other words, think of a company like Beauty Counter. That's not typically what you would call a fitness, health, and wellness company, but a lot of ladies that I know, in fact, I've interviewed several of them for the Kelly O Show podcast, link below, in our business series, many of them are Beauty Counter reps and they're making some fantastic income, anywhere from a couple $1,000s a month to $5,000 a month. Some of them are getting, you know, free makeup and making $500-$700 a month. So it's anywhere in those midlines. And some folks are making a tremendous income, but that's not specifically a fitness, health, and wellness company, but it doesn't matter because when you are influential in fitness, health, and wellness, people will also look to you for, I mean, look at me. I started off as a fitness vlogger and a fitness blogger, and now people come to me for business tips and I have business services. You never know what you're going to end up doing. You just keep being yourself and doing what it is that you're really good at. Follow your passion. Inevitably, there's going to be people that want to pay you to do that if you look for it.